Watch as Jim McKay gives us an idea of this man's life and time.
This is the South Tyrol, the part of northern Italy where they still speak German, and where, like northern New England, farmers really don't chat a lot, especially with strangers. The center of life is the village church. What was it like to grow up around here?
There are not many things to say about that. I grew up on a farm. In winter, it's very tough. We had to go down by foot or by sled to school, and then pull the sled back up again later. Completely normal people here. Otherwise, there aren't many problems.
No, not so many problems. A knee operation in 1981, but then a World Cup singles championship in 1982. Not a bad life for a 28-year-old bachelor with a nice red car and a girlfriend only two villages away. He lives here at home for the time being, the last of nine children to be brought up in this big old farmhouse. His father, now 78, presides at the supper table where they still preserve an old mountain tradition. It used to be so difficult to get flour to the upper mountain towns that the baking had to be done all at once while the flour was still fresh. So every 6 months, the women would bake bread. It would get harder and harder until it was so tough they'd have to use a special tool to chip the bread into usable portions. For Ernst now, though, it's time to move on to a place of his own. With some friends, he's building some apartments. And this is the one he's chosen for himself. It's been a dream of his for some time now. And even though he's seen a good bit of the outside world, he'd never really consider living anywhere else.
Well,
I prefer to stay here because I like the silence. And I've grown up here. Live in the city? I don't know. They're too tight.
Here,
if you have a problem, you just go into the woods and pretty much I can solve the problems there.
Or perhaps walking up the luge run, dreaming of Olympic gold.
This is the face of Ernst Haspinger, northern Italian who was the leader at the end of the first run. But when I say leader, it wasn't by very much. His name appeared at the top of the board, but right underneath him were three men, all almost at the same time. So Jeff, on his mind now, he hasn't got a lead to consolidate. He is in a four-way race for the lead.
That's absolutely true, Sam. It was so close yesterday that it might as well have been a tie, and it's almost a new race again today. He's got to be the fastest again today, basically to keep the lead. But Ernst is completely capable of that. As we saw yesterday, he's very quick, a very fine slider.
28 years old, and one of the more experienced men on the hill. Now, there's the split time. No, disappointing, very disappointing for Ernst Haspinger. What do you think his experience means to him in conditions like this? But the track, obviously, is not ideal.
What can you say? He's seen all conditions. He's been around on different tracks. I think he can handle this. I think he'll have a good run. Although that first split wasn't indicative.
Well, and neither was the second one. Here he comes around and takes the finish. No, Ernst Haspinger, 2/10 off. That is going to be a disappointment for him. It may not seem like very much time to talk about 2/10 of a second, but the way this competition is developing, this could be a serious setback for Ernst Haspinger. And Jeff, I think he knows it. Yesterday we saw him exultant at the end of the run. Not now.
At the top of the hill, roughly 400 feet above the place he hopes to finish, just 40 seconds roughly after he begins, Torsten Gerlitzer of East Germany, a man that yesterday astonished the losing world, Jeff, with his achievement, moving into second place, just a fraction out of the lead. Torsten Gerlitzer, a real surprise here.
Absolutely, Sam. He has limited international experience. He's probably only been seen in three or four races in international competition, yet he showed up here with the East German team, and bingo, he's in second place.
All right, now, is the possibility he, so to speak, got lucky, I don't mean to use that phrase lightly, yesterday, and now today, with the snow as bad as it is and everything, that the conditions will really test it? We'll have to see.
You do not get lucky in this sport, Sam. You got to go out there and do the job. There's no such thing as luck in the sport of luge.
All right, so today we'll see if he can back up what he did yesterday, and that is a pretty good
good time under the circumstances. If anything, the track seems to be getting a little slower as the competition goes on, don't you think?
It really does, Sam. Even though they're sweeping, there seems to be sections like that big straightaway we just saw that have some snow in them, and it's got to be affecting the times right now. You can see the snow. You can make it out. It's coming down like crazy.
All right, Torsten Gerlacher at the very bottom of the course. This is the last turn. He was in second at the end of the competition yesterday. He's now taken the lead today. Torsten Gerlacher again yesterday. Not so fast over the upper part, and then he astonished us, Jeff, with his performance over the lower part of the track. This man knows something about the lower part of this track, which includes those high G turns in the labyrinth that nobody else does.
Now, this is really fascinating. It demonstrates the depth of the East German talent, that they can come up with this guy who has seen limited international experience, hasn't had the training that some of the people have in this track, yet he comes out and smokes two runs. It's really, really incredible, Sam.